Hello and welcome to another episode of Zero to Hero in Fusion 360. Today, we're going to be making a packet of medicines which looks something like this. Alright, so without any further ado, let's get started already. Now, as usual, start by creating a sketch. So we're first going to create the top plastic covering which holds the capsules. So for that, we're going to need a half of the capsule to basically be at the top, and inside that we're going to be keeping our capsules. So I've created this particular sketch in which we're going to draw a circle of radius of diameter 0.5 centimeters, and hit OK. Zoom in if it's too small and say finish sketch. Right, again zoom in if it's too small, and now extrude this to form a cylinder. I'm going to extrude it by 0.5 centimeters and hit OK. Now what we want to do is we want to have spheres on both of these faces. So let's say create, and we're going to say sphere, right? Now it's going to ask you to choose a plane. I'm going to choose this plane, which is the front face of this particular cylinder that we just created. If that's not clearly visible for you, you can hit front view and then choose that surface. And now it's going to ask you to place the center. So I'm going to press the center point of this particular cylinder. And now it's going to ask me for a diameter. I'm going to set that to be the same as what we had for the cylinder itself. So that'll be 0.5 centimeter. But as you may notice, it's actually showing a red colored sphere, which means that it's going to cut away whatever material it finds in its path. All right. And that's not what we want. So what we want to do is we want to join that particular sphere with the rest of the cylinder. So for that, we have to choose the operation to be join. All right. And then hit OK. Similarly, do it for the backside. So create sphere, choose the face, choose the center, and choose 0.5 centimeter and change that to join. Hit OK, and that's going to create a capsule shaped object for us. All right. Now what we want to do is we want to basically split this into two halves. That is the top part and the bottom part. And we don't need the bottom part. We just need the top half for actually forming the plastic covering inside which the capsules are going to be placed. So we're going to use the split tool for that. All right. So we're going to choose split body, and we're going to choose this entire capsule as our body to split. And for the splitting tools, we're going to be selecting this particular plane, that is the flat plane along the ground, to be the splitting tool. What that's going to do is it's going to divide this into two separate parts. All right. And that is exactly what we want. So I'm going to hit OK. Now it has basically split the body into two parts. And as you can see, there's an extra line going along its length. Now, if you go to your browser and go under bodies, then you will see now there are two separate bodies, body one, which is the bottom half, and body two, which is the top half. We no longer need body one, so we can right click that and choose remove. All right, so that removes the bottom part of the capsule that we have created. And that actually comes up as a separate item on our timeline. All right, so now if you actually went back, you would again get back your complete capsule, right? So let's go back to the present moment. And now what we want to do is we want to basically extrude this bottom profile to give it a certain amount of depth. And so we're going to choose the extrude tool and select this particular profile plane as the plane to be extruded, and set that to about 0.1 centimeters, maybe more if you want, but I think 0.1 is fine. And then hit OK, right? So that gives you this kind of a shape, which is typical of
the plastic part of a medicine packet.
So yeah, now we're gonna make this into a shell, because this is a completely solid body. We don't want a completely solid body. We just want a shell to be the outer part of that particular medicine holding thing. So we're gonna choose shell tool over here. And then we have to choose the face along which we want to make a shell. All right. So if you choose this surface and then you just move this by a little bit, you'll see that you get exactly what you want. Right. It makes a shell in the exact direction in which we want. If you choose other faces, you will also get some results, but those will not be what we want here. So just choose that face and try it. And inside thickness, 0.05 centimeter looks a bit too thick. So maybe 0.01. You can play around with these values. I'm going to go with maybe 0.02 because that looks too thin, right? So this is fine. Now we're going to give this a material, which is, I mean, an appearance. So hit A for appearance and search for clear, right? You'll get acrylic clear. And if you haven't downloaded it, it'll show you a download icon. You can just click that. I have already downloaded it, so that's not coming up for me. All right, and then I'm going to drag this and drop it onto this particular body. So now it's showing up as a clear object, right? And I can say close. So that's that. Now what we want to do is we don't want a single capsule, obviously. We want maybe a 4x4 capsule packet or whatever, 4x5 or whatever it is really. So now what we're going to do is we're going to create a rectangular pattern, all right? So a rectangular pattern, what it does is it actually allows you to choose one object and
make copies of that object.
So we can choose this complete object. In fact, the pattern type shouldn't be faces. It should be set to bodies. All right. Then you can choose the entire body at once. And directions, you want to first extend along this line. You can choose that, or you can choose to extend along this line. Don't extend along this line because that's going to give you capsules one above the other, which is not how it happens. They generally pack from left to right or front to back. So click this one. And now it's going to ask you for what is either you can choose spacing, in which case it's going to give you a constant amount of spacing between all of them, or you can hit extend, in which case you can basically specify the extent to which it should be spread out. And that will basically subdivide that much of distance by the number of items you want. So right now we have 3. If I increase that to 4, it'll try to fit 4 within that exact same amount. And if I again increase that to 5, again, it'll try to fit 5 in that exact same length. That's not what we really want. I'm going to set that back to 3, actually 4, because we're going to use 4, but I'm going to choose this to be spacing. All right, so I want a constant spacing between all of them. And in this case, if I switch from, say, 4 to 5, it's not going to move any of them. It's just going to add an extra fifth one to the left of that. All right. So I'm going to hit OK. And so we have 5 right now. In fact, I didn't want 5. I just wanted 4. So again, rectangular pattern, choose this body. In case that was set to faces, choose bodies, choose this. And the directions, I'm going to extend along this direction. That is, I want a pattern in this direction. Set this to be spacing rather than extent, and increase the quantity up to 4, and just make it a reasonably large value so that it doesn't look like they're too close together, and at the same time it shouldn't look like they're too far apart either. You know, you'd know when you make it, because you've seen a lot of capsule packets. So this is just to be done by hand. There's no real need to actually choose a specific value here. You can play around with that, right? So hit OK. Next, what we want to do is we don't want just a single row of capsules, obviously. We want a complete array of them, like a 2x2 array. So again, choose rectangular pattern, and this time choose all the 4 objects, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. So just choose all of them. Then the direction this time is, again, this time we want it to be extending in the forward direction. So we're going to choose that and increase the length to a sufficiently large length so that they don't look like they're cluttered again. So 1.15 looks all right to me, maybe 1.2, right? And then increase this up to maybe 4 or 5. And if you want to see the entire view, go to your top view, do a couple of rotations, and you know how to, you know your way around Fusion by now. So there we have 4x4, that is 16 capsules made for us, right? That's not capsules, those are just the packets, or rather the coverings inside which the capsules will be. So then we hit OK. That gives us 16 separate capsule holders, right? Now what we want to do is we want to make that plain surface, which is underneath the entire thing. That is basically that foil, which protects the capsules from falling out or basically from the air and everything. So yeah. We're going to create that. First, we have to create a sketch. So go to your bottom view and choose and start create sketch. And now don't choose the bottom plane, rather choose one of these planes. All right. So one of the planes of these capsules that you've just created, the bottom plane, that's going to give us the bottom plane underneath all of these capsules rather than a plane, which is, you know, intersecting with these capsules. All right. So again, hit bottom view. And now what we want is we want to create a rectangle. So hit 2-point rectangle here and choose any 2 points. Basically, I'm going to choose this one and It should hopefully look symmetric. Mine doesn't for some reason, but you can always set the values so that it looks symmetric in the in the end, because that's going to make a slight difference, right? So yeah, I think this is going to be fine, but yeah, okay, this looks fine. Now just choose the fillet tool and cut off this particular corner and that one and that and this one as well, right? So then say finish sketch. And so now we have a bottom surface for this. Don't worry if it's not symmetric like mine is. Really, in real life also, the most of the medicine capsules, the capsule packets aren't completely symmetric, and it's fine unless you're going for engineering degree of precision. This is not going to be a problem, right? So yeah, now just extrude this a little bit to give it a little bit of depth. Select this, and when you go to the bottom surface, again, what happened to us when we were making the pencil is going to happen. You have to again choose this plane as well and then extrude. Otherwise, it's going to give you a cavity of that particular shape at the bottom, right? We don't want it to be this thick because really that's quite unrealistic. So maybe choose 0.01 centimeters, right? That looks more realistic, but in fact, it looks too thin. So maybe 0.05 would be a better choice, all right? So yeah, then I'm going to hit OK, and we have this is as our final capsule packet, right? So yeah, now if you want to put capsules inside of this, you can do that by just creating a separate capsule like similar to how we had created the packet for the capsules. You can create a single capsule. So you can just do that by saying create sketch, choose this plane, and basically creating a circle of slightly smaller diameter, and then again applying the rectangular pattern tool object. I'm not going to be doing that again here because it's going to be pretty repetitive, so you can do that for yourselves. And so yeah, I hope this video was quite informative and useful for you, and I hope you learned something from this. And if you liked it, smash like, subscribe to us, and if you have any doubts, feel free to post it down in the comments below. So yeah, bye, peace.